in one's experience is that revolution conversion is not completely possible. The sole way we have out of the domination of metaphysics is what he calls Verbindung, a term which he finds in the everyday German language, which imprints in a specific way, opposing it as a feasible alternative to the Überwindung, to the of metaphysics, which would mean like the complete overcoming of metaphysics. If we think of our current condition in the light of the Heideggerian notion of Verbindung, both the meaning of the current condition of our world and the possibility of modifying it in some sense may appear under a different light. First of all, as it was decisive for Heidegger himself, we shall no longer consider conversion and radical transformation as a matter of individual choice. This, as you may remember, is the sense of the disappearance in Heidegger's works of the very term of Eigentlichkeit, authenticity, in favor of the term of Ereignis, which significantly has the same verbal root. Ereignis means event, but Eigen is always the same. So you could translate Ereignis with appropriation, and Eigentlichkeit is authenticity. So from a certain point on in Heidegger's work, you don't find any longer the term and the notion of Eigentlichkeit. Why? Verkehre, the turning point of the 30s, he experienced it in the 30s, leads Heidegger from the original existentialist attitude to the more explicitly ontological position of the late works. Conversion is a business or a matter of being itself, not of our individual relationship to beings. This is, at the very end, the reason for connecting explicitly the theme of conversion and catastrophe, for me at least, to the notion of the possibility or impossibility of revolution. Such a change in philosophical perspective has to do with the end of metaphysics in the sense that it is exactly in the world of the end of metaphysics, the Gestell, the general domination of technical rationalization, that men and world lose the traits given to them by metaphysics, i.e. the traits of subject and object. This is another reference to identitet und Differenz, but it's very interesting because why in the Gestell metaphysics comes to an end and opens up the possibility of Verbindung? Because in the late metaphysical world, man and world lose the traits metaphysics that had always attributed to them, subject and object. Now, what did Heidegger have in mind by saying that? I really probably didn't understand very well, but I think that he was anticipating something which is very similar to our network, to our internet world, to our... Take, for instance, the difficulties to establish the rules of the intellectual property in the internet. Do you really... What is Wikipedia? Is something which is a mixture of what I... And, of course, there is probably a control, but I don't know how far it goes, the control. I mean, in many senses, in the late technological world, the relation of separation of subject to object is put into discussion, at least. And this probably Heidegger wanted to say. There is no longer that objectivism of the, which was classic in modern philosophy, but much of what is described by sociologists and analysts of social psychology and of social and political attitudes falls into the categories outlined here by Heidegger, starting with the feeling of the lack of authentic event that is expressed also by our title here. The developed or endometaphysics world shows a worrying absence of projectuality if one accepts the effort of preserving the existing way of life, which is with its privileges and habits of consumption, which is the root of the war on terrorism which we are fighting. The third world, on its side, is dominated by the same model, strives to reach the same level of well-being and of consumption which the West has exported everywhere. Plus ça change, plus c'est la même chose, says a word in French, I don't know if it is a quotation of a great author, but plus ça change, plus c'est la même chose means that the more it changes, the more it's the same thing. The difficulty Heidegger experiences in his effort to overcome metaphysics is also the meaning of our experience with the dream and the impossibility of conversion. Let me just repeat that the reason why I take the liberty to connect the lack of event to the end of metaphysics is related to the fact that end of metaphysics in Heidegger is the Gestalt, the totalization of the technological domination, so to speak, total verwaltung, as the Dorner used to say, but not in the same sense as Heidegger. At any rate, it is a sort of conditional net. There is a net surrounding the world which is a strong net. Now, what about the possibility of escaping metaphysics not through an interwindum, but at least by a movement of verbindung? May it be a real way out, or does it remain at the level of an ironical and merely subjective attitude of detachment vis-à-vis the metaphysical, technological, economic, political existing order? Can we at the very end expect some kind of conversion which would not be simply the ironic acceptance of things as they are? I come now to explain what verbindung means finally, because I remarked that I didn't translate it very much. As already said, verbindung is a common term which means basically convalescence, the fact of bringing in oneself the traces of a previous illness from which one has recovered. Understood this way, verbindung seems marked by a purely passive attitude, a sort of ontological fatalism, which reminds us of the moment of stoicism and skepticism in Hegel's Phenomenology. I would prefer to emphasize more deeply another implication of the term, I made already an allusion to. The prefix ver, for instance, verstehen, which means understand, even in English, understand. Put yourself in my shoes. Verstehen, translate you to my position. I don't know, but it means that the prefix ver is not always, but sometimes means a sort of change, distortion, change of direction in the movement, which does not involve anything radically new, but only a diversion. The importance of the notion of verbindung resides totally in this allusion to a change which appears to be possible instead of overcoming and revolution, exactly because it is, does not involve the strength and violence of a general reversal of the kind Nietzsche had in mind when he spoke, without exactly understanding it completely, of Umwertung aller Werte, transformation of our world, values. Is this change so slight and silent that it can be only an inner spiritual change? When he took part with Hitler in 1933, Heidegger did not think of a purely intimate conversion. This is